Welcome to your midweek motivation. It's hard to believe that it's Wednesday already, but the middle of the week is here. There's a phrase for it that we stole from a commercial a number of years ago called hump day. In fact, when my kids were little, it was something we used to say all the time. Guess what day it is? Guess what day it is? Hump day. In fact, my brother had an opportunity to go overseas on a trip to the Middle East, and he came back and he brought a camel with him. Because for a while, my family used to use that phrase all the time. Well, it's hump day. It's the day in the middle of the week where we are now over the hump. And this is the day where sometimes you need a little bit more oomph to get you there, a little bit more push, a little bit more woo in your life. So this is that moment, your midweek motivation. Well, hopefully you're motivated wherever you're at watching this because it's a beautiful day. It's not a beautiful day where I am. There have been so many things in our culture, in our world at large, in general this year, where you sit there going, really, 2020? Are you kidding me? There have been not only cultural issues that are going on, specifically here in the United States, all over the world with COVID, there have been protests, there have been all sorts of things. But have you noticed the weather? The weather's been a little kooky too, with hurricanes in the Gulf Coast, off the coast here in the United States. With the weather changing as rapidly as it has, it's been one of those where you're like, what is going on? Just yesterday in Denver, Colorado, it snowed. It was 90 some degrees in Denver, and literally the next day it was in the 30s. They had a 60 degree swing in one day. Only the second time in the history of record keeping back to the 1800s where something like that has happened. What is going on? Well, you know what? You could say that about a lot of different aspects of life today. You can ask the question, what is going on? One of the things that you can ask that about is the rise to fame that a number of pastors have had recently in our culture. And maybe you're not watching it because you're not a part of the church culture, but I am. I've been watching it and paying attention to it. And we've seen a number of pastors just shoot to stardom recently within our current cultural context, like literally overnight. Overnight, they've developed this following. In fact, I'll give you an example. There was a pastor that had to start a Facebook page, didn't have a Facebook page, but had to start a Facebook page because of their shot to stardom. When their friend limit was exceeded on Facebook, they started a Facebook page, and literally within 2 days, it went from zero to 100,000 followers. Well, what's the trick? What's the key? Why are these people shooting to stardom? Why are they becoming famous all the time, all of a sudden? At this time, especially pastors. Why are people listening to pastors? What in the world is going on? Well, I noticed a few trends, a few things, a few similarities within these pastors that all of a sudden became something. And it was this: one, they were super conservative. Two, they believed that the Bible was infallible, that it was true in everything that it said. They believed in inerrancy of Scripture. Three, they'd been pastors for a while. It's not like they were brand new and all of a sudden people had heard them and they just became something overnight. They've been doing this for a number of years. But then the fourth thing was what really caught my eye, and that was this: a conservative political news organization caught a hold of either one of their videos or one of their posts and they reposted it, and all of a sudden they became famous. Which poses the question, what in the world is going on? Because these guys, these pastors, became famous, not for the message that they were preaching, but the political stance that they were taking. It wasn't because of the message that they had, the message of Jesus, the message of the gospel, but rather the political nature of what it was that they were saying. Over the last couple of weeks, I've said, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to make it political. I want to keep it biblical. And so this is week three. Week number three of saying, let's make it biblical, not political. Because see, here's the deal. I could do the same thing. I understand the words that need to be spoken. In fact, I'm watching it happen in our culture. I could tell you all the hot button topics that I could speak into and say just what it is that people want to hear. And all of a sudden tomorrow, I could possibly have 100,000 followers on Facebook. And that's not what I want. In fact, as we watch that happening, we should sit there going, is anybody concerned about this? As we've looked at our culture, as we've looked at the weather, each one of us has said, Is there something weird going on? And I think the same thing holds true in our church culture and in the culture of Christianity today. We need to ask the question, is this weird? Paul, a number of years ago, wrote to a disciple of his called Timothy. And he actually said that this is exactly what would happen. Paul said this to Timothy. He wrote, "Preach the word. Be prepared in season and out of season. Correct, rebuke, and encourage with great patience and careful instruction. For the time will come when people will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear." For many years, I'd heard that passage in regards to the world around us, hearing what it was that they wanted to hear. And yet, as I read this over the last couple of weeks, what I've come to realize is that Paul was speaking to Timothy and giving him his charge within the church. That Timothy needed to preach the word in the church because those that were part of the church would put people around them that allowed their itching ears to hear what they wanted to hear. Hey, church, it's happening today. We are listening to people who are saying what we want them to say. And our challenge and our motivation this week is maybe we should do it differently. When was the last time you liked a pastor's page because he made you uncomfortable? When was the last time you posted something because it convicted you and made you turn from the error of your ways? When was the last time a pastor shot to fame because of the words that he spoke in love to a world that needs Jesus, rather than the political stance that he took? That is awfully convicting. What is it that we're listening to today? What is it that we're hearing? Let's do this. Let's make sure we make it biblical and not political. And let's listen to lots of different voices. Don't just listen to the ones that tickle your ears and that give you the words that you want to hear. Rather, listen to the messages that make you go, ugh. One of those messages in our world today is that this election coming up, it won't save you. That's a message that makes a lot of people go, because see, regardless of who gets elected, it's not going to change anything. The only thing that truly changes is the message of Jesus. And that's the message that needs to be preached today. Hey, Timothy, in season and out of season, preach the message. Right now, we're in a season where it's kind of not a season to preach the message because nobody wants to hear it. So here's the message. It's Jesus. And I'm going to keep preaching it. And my hope is that pastors will become famous because they're preaching the message of Jesus, not because of the political stance that they're taking. So this week, my motivation to you and my challenge to you is, like the posts that make you kind of cringe, share the pages of pastors that make you sit there going, oh, I don't know if I want to hear that message, but I really need to. And share the things that will change this world. And those things are the messages of Jesus Christ when he said, love your enemies, pray for those that persecute you. You don't need to win anything. It's already been won. And the victory was at the cross. And that message makes a lot of people uncomfortable. And yet, that's the message that needs to be preached. So hopefully this week, you're motivated. You're challenged to make it biblical, not political. Have a great week. See you next week.